The protagonist is the wolf, the deuteragonist is the hawk. Together they shall wed very early. All being said, it was a very interesting story coming forward. Hi, I'm Andrew from Hypersanity Books, and today I will be reviewing The Wolf and the Hawk. Otherwise, let's get into it. Today's review is a romance fantasy novel written by Julian Greystoke, who has written The Wolf and the Hawk. This particular story was quite surprising. It starts off where the protagonist is arranged by her father to marry a king into a kingdom. So she's gone from one lifestyle that's very much into a survival pack. The first chapter starts off very nicely. The description of the weapons is good. The way she uses the weapons is fantastic. She has a lot of ability. Being a dominant character, this worked really well for the story. She has a couple other characters that are by her side as bodyguards. They come along on the journey as well. So she's the alpha in the wolf pack. She's human, but it's just the way the analogy goes. The other supporting characters in her group go with her to this kingdom where she meets someone by the name of Alexander. He then asks to be called Xander. Within the story, she gets wed really quickly. The way the wedding dress is explained is interesting. The tattoos that she has on her body, she has the majority of tattoos and ink in her tribe because that is a display of her dominance because of her contribution to their side. With this particular marriage and allegiance, she's making the best of the situation. And the main reason she's making the best of the situation is because this guy is a muscle-bound person, chiseled, long blonde hair. There's a certain part, she's just accepting it. They have this bit of a sensual moment where they do what they should do on a wedding night, and it wasn't explicit. This was really well done. There are certain emotions and feelings that she has, though there is a big acceptance trying to make the best of things for the greater good of people. Within the kingdom, she works doing certain mediocre jobs, understanding the people. There was a lot of really good characterization with this character while she still remained dominant. There's a particular point I found was hilarious where another character is chuckling at her and she purposely scratches the back of her neck, purposely flexing her bicep to show off her dominance. The character, the body language is fantastic in this book. With the story, we look at elements of a story. The setting is good, the plot is good, the theme is good. One of the stronger points is the theme. With elements of a story, there's so much good. But the part that makes the rest of it dominate over everything else is the characterization of the main character. I didn't take too much to the hawk, which is the husband, the deuteragonist. Now, he was an alright character, he was well written, but this particular protagonist, seeing things from her point of view, was fascinating. There's even a scene break where she's having a dream of taming a drake, basically a dragon. She's doing the Chuck Norris thing. That in itself just put this dominance from one level to another and another, where she is a very goal-orientated character. But she's also trying to understand what is best for the people. Within the halfway point of the story comes into a little bit of conflict where Xander doesn't want to introduce her to the father because they've had certain tiffs and quarrels. Now, with this particular point, she makes her point quite clear that their relationship is only in early stages. it is a rushed arranged marriage. So they haven't had the chance to properly have a relationship develop. And I think the way she stood her ground with him was good, but she was also not completely disrespectful. One thing I do see in a lot of fiction, when you do have a difference between a dominant female and a male, the balance goes so far with the scale where it becomes a marginalized relationship. There will be a topic on types of relationships, but a marginalized relationship will not work. It has to be equals. There is still the part of trying to be equals but separated, and that's not healthy. Sometimes you have to do your own thing in your world, but come together for the relationship. This is really well handled how she does this. With the story moving forward, there's a bit of sneaking around to follow him on his journey, meeting up, even at a particular point having her two bodyguards talk to his couple bodyguards, asking questions. The story unfolds that little bit where there's different sexual orientations between different characters, and it wasn't such a bad gripe to the story. It was, what was good about this was the characters were just getting along and being enjoyable to be around as it's unfolding a little bit more about each character within the party. This also established the relationship to build up as conflict became worse, gets to leading on towards the third act, you would say, where they're rallying troops, getting ready for a big war, defending the castle. This story had so much happening, even though it was still fast-paced. The main problem and the bigger gripe, as good as some things were, it could have been better, but the main character just dominates over the power of everything. And I'm not saying that Xander's character wasn't an equal balance between the protagonist and deuteragonist. It's just her character was just that much more interesting and enjoyable to read and be around. Otherwise, his character was still good, just not quite as enjoyable. Other characters were okay in the story, but the focus was from her point of view. The way she worked within, previously mentioned, with other characters and within the people, she is a good character. That's it for this review. I rate it 3.5 out of 5 stars. I am curious to see how this author is going to improve and continuously improve on her next book, because she is a very goal-orientated person, and I admire that. Now, that being said, that's it for today. Hit like, subscribe, comment. At the end of this video, there'll be a link to her channel. Go check it out. Hit like, subscribe, comment. Have a look. Check it out. Otherwise, a big shout out to you for allowing me to review your book. Thank you, Julian. That's it, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.